Welcome everybody. Today we are going to discuss about JK flip-flop in the Tinkercad. We will try to understand operation of JK flip-flop with the help of Tinkercad. In Tinkercad, you will find one IC, that is 7473. So what is 7473? So 7473 is a IC which internally has two JK flip-flop. So inside single 7473 IC, you will find how many JK flip-flop? 2 JK flip-flop. So let's assume that here we have first JK flip-flop. Let's label it as flip-flop 1. Okay. And here suppose we have second JK flip-flop. Let's label it as flip-flop 2. Then a block diagram of JK flip-flop is somewhat like this. In JK flip-flop, we have two inputs J and K. These two inputs are called as synchronous input because their operation is dependent on the clock. Then in JK flip-flop, we also have preset input and we also have clear input. Then in JK flip-flop, there are two outputs. First one is Q and second one is Q prime or Q bar. Now let's try to understand pin diagram of 7473. So pin number 1 present in 7473 act as clock for flip-flop 1. Okay, so pin number 1 present in 7473 acts as clock for flip-flop 1. Then what is use of pin number 2? So pin number 2 act as clear input for flip-flop 1. So pin number 2 is going to act as clear input. Pin number 3 will act as K input for flip-flop 1. Pin number 4 will act as VCC. So pin number 4 should be connected to VCC. Then pin number 5 will act as clock for flip-flop 2. So by using pin number 5, what you can do, you can provide clock to second JK flip-flop which is present in 7473 IC. Pin number 6 will act as clear input for flip-flop 2. Pin number 7 will act as J input for flip-flop 2. Pin number 8 will act as Q2 prime. Okay, it will act as Q prime for flip-flop 2. Pin number 9 act as Q output for flip-flop 2. Pin number 10 act as K input for flip-flop 2. So this is about flip-flop 2. Then we have remaining pins that are related with flip-flop 1. For example, pin number 14. Pin number 14 will act as J input for flip-flop 1. Pin number 13 will act as Q prime. Pin number 13 will act as Q prime for flip-flop 1. And pin number 12 will act as Q output for flip-flop 1. And pin number 11 should be connected to ground. So this is pin diagram of 7473. Now let's try to understand operation of JK flip-flop. So in JK flip-flop, there are four possibility. That is, J and K both will be 0, 0, or J will be 0, K will be 1, or J is 1, K is 0, or J and K both are 1, 1. So in JK flip-flop, if both inputs are 0, 0, then there is no change. There is no change in state of JK flip-flop. Means what? If present state of JK flip-flop is 0, then next state of JK flip-flop will be 0. If present state is 1, then next state of JK flip-flop will be 1. There is no change. Then if J is 0 and K is 1, it is called as a reset condition. So in this case, JK flip-flop is going to reset. Means what? If present state of JK flip-flop is 0, then it will remain 0 only. And if present state of JK flip-flop is 1, then it will become 0. If J is 1 and K is 0, then this is called as set condition in JK flip-flop. So what it indicate? It indicate that if present state of JK flip-flop is 0, then next state of JK flip-flop will be 1. If present state is 1, then next state will be 1. So if J is 1 and K is 0, then next state of JK flip-flop will be always 1. So that's why it is called as set condition. Then in JK flip-flop, if both inputs are 1-1, then what will happen? Then JK flip-flop will toggle. JK flip-flop will toggle means if present state of JK flip-flop is 0, then it will become 1. If present state of JK flip-flop is 1, then it will become 0. So this is operation of JK flip-flop. So in Google, just type Tinkercad. You will get one website labeled as tinkercad.com. Open it. Website. So here you should click on circuit, then create new circuit. After that, here I will add one breadboard to our circuit. So see, one breadboard has been added. Then I will add power supply. So here just type power supply. So here you can see the power supply, add it, perform drag and drop operation. So power supply has two terminal, positive, negative. So I will take connection from this positive terminal and I will connect this positive terminal of this power supply to one of the point present in this bottommost row. Now let's change color of this wire to red. Then I will take connection from negative terminal of power supply and I will connect this negative terminal of power supply to one of the point which is present in this particular row. So due to this, what is going to happen? All the points which are present in this bottommost row, they are going to act as VCC. So here I will take connection from one of the point present in this bottommost row and I will connect it to one of the point that is present in this second row of the breadboard. So let's change color of this wire again to red. Then I will take one more connection, okay, from this point and I will connect that particular point suppose to this point which is present in first row of the breadboard. So now what is going to happen? All the points which are present in this second row, they are going to act as VCC. All the points which are present in this first row, they are going to act as ground. So power supply is added. Now let's add 74 73 IC. So 74 73 IC is added. Now 74 73 IC contain JK flip-flop and we know that JK flip-flop or each and every flip-flop requires clock pulse. So by using this function generator, we are going to generate the clock that will be required for flip-flop. So here let's add function generator to our circuit. So function generator again has two terminal, positive terminal, negative terminal. So what you should do, you should connect negative terminal of this function generator to the ground. So where is ground? So we know that all the points which are present in this particular row, they are going to act as ground. Then what to do with this positive terminal? So this positive terminal should be connected to clock input pin of 7473. So let's see pin diagram of 7473. So if you observe this pin diagram, then here you will come to know that pin number 1 is acting as clock input for flip-flop 1. So here what I will do, I will connect this positive terminal of function generator to pin number 1 of 7473. So this is input pin, so let's change its color to suppose purple. Then what is use of pin number 2?
So see, pin number 2, it acts as clear input. So clear input, we know that it is active low input. If you want to use it, then it should be connected to logic 0. I don't want to use this pin number 2. I don't want to use clear input. So that's why I am going to connect pin number 2 to logic 1. So pin number 2 should be connected to logic 1. And where we have logic 1, so all the points which are present in this bottom most row, they are going to act as logic 1. So again, this is input, so let's change its color to purple. Then what is use of pin number 3? So pin number 3 act as K input. So by using this K input, I can give either 1 or 0 as input to JK flip-flop. So in order to give this 1 and 0 as an input, in Tinkercad, what I will do, I will add one slide switch. So how many slide switch I am going to add? So I am going to add 2 slide switch. So first slide switch will be required for J input and second slide switch will be required for K input. So let's assume that this slide switch is corresponding to J input. So here I will add one label. Suppose this is J input, and I will add one more label. So let's assume that this slide switch, it corresponds to K input. Now slide switch has 3 terminals. So terminal 1 can be connected to the VCC. So let's change its color to red. And terminal 2 should be connected to ground. Then here also terminal 1 should be connected to VCC. And terminal 2 should be connected to ground. Now this is VCC, so let's change its color to red. Now pin number 3 should be connected to K input. So this slide switch has common terminal. So this common terminal should be connected to pin number 3 of 7473. So let's take connection from this pin number 3. And let us connect it to common terminal of this second slide switch. So again, this is input, so let's change its color to purple. So pin number 3 is over. What is use of pin number 4? So pin number 4 should be connected to VCC. So take connection from pin number 4 and connect it to the VCC. So let us change its color to red. Then pin number 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, they correspond to second JK flip-flop. Let's assume that I don't want to use this second JK flip-flop. So I will not use these pins, pin number 5 to 10. Then pin number 11 should be connected to ground. So where is pin number 11? So this is pin number 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So pin number 11 should be connected to ground. So here we have ground. Already I told you that all the points present in this first row, they are going to act as ground. So next pin, pin number 12. Pin number 12 act as Q output of first JK flip-flop. So this pin number 12 should be connected to output. So here, in order to implement output, we will add one LED. So LED is added. Now here we will also require the register. So let us add a register. So let's rotate it. So we'll connect one terminal of register to a cathode terminal of the LED. And what to do with this anode terminal? So see, anode terminal of LED should be connected to output pin of 7473. So which is output pin of 7473? Okay, so pin number 12. So this is pin number 12. So I will take connection from this pin number 12 and I will connect it to anode terminal of the LED. Now this is output. So for output, let's use suppose pink color. Then what to do with this other terminal of a register? So other terminal of register should be connected to ground. Then pin number 13. Pin number 13 is Q prime. That is second output of this first JK flip-flop. So let's assume that I don't want to use this second output. Then pin number 14. Pin number 14 is going to act as J input for first JK flip-flop. So pin number 14. So where is pin number 14? So this is pin number 14. So this pin number 14 is going to act. So this particular slide switch is going to act as J input. So I will connect pin number 14 to common terminal of this slide switch. Now this is input, so let's change its color to purple. So in this way, what we did, we have completed connections for first JK flip-flop present in 747. Now let's start the simulation. Now after starting simulation, here you can see that output is at logic 1. Now if we observe this input, so what is current state of J and K? So see, this slide switch has one strip, black and white strip, and that black and white strip is on left hand side. And what we have done, we have connected this terminal 1 of this slide switch to the VCC. So I can say that current state of this J input is 1. Similarly, you can verify that current state of this K input is also 1. So J and K both are 1-1. So in case of JK flip-flop, we know that when both inputs are at logic 1, output toggle. So can we see this particular effect here? No. Why it is so? It is due to this function generator. Now let's click on this function generator. So here you can see some settings related with function generator. So what is frequency of the clock pulse that is generated by function generator? It is 1000. So I will change this frequency to 5 hertz. Okay, so as soon as I change frequency of the clock pulse that is generated by this function generator to 5 hertz, I can see toggle operation. Okay, so see, here output of JK flip-flop is now continuously toggling. It is continuously changing from 1 to 0 and 0 to 1. Why it is so? It is due to J and K. J and K both inputs are at logic 1. Now let's change suppose state of J. Now I will make J 0. So J is 0 and K is 1. So this is a reset condition in JK flip-flop. Okay, so see, here output is at logic 0. It is reset. Now let's change J input to 1 and K input to 0. So when J is 1 and K is 0, so this is set condition. So see, here output of JK flip-flop is at logic 1. It is set. And when both inputs are at logic 0, when both inputs are at logic 0, then there is no change in state of JK flip-flop. So in this way, we have verified working of JK flip-flop by using Tinkercad.